Hi guys, this is David O'Rourke here. We're going to talk about today, we're going to make a Lazy Boy double mouse station. That's what we're going to perform today so that we can get work done from one computer and another computer. Oop, that's a little big one. Okay, we're going to make a mouse station where these dang dumb mouses don't fall off the floor and run around the floor. That's right. We'll keep the cats away. Okay, we're going to make this mouse station for the armchair. Lazy Boy armchair mouse station. Stay tuned. Next. Hi, guys. This is next. We're going to get some measurement. We're going to make it 22 inches long and mouse pad size 8 to 8.5. I'd say about 8. Sounds good to me. So 22 by 8. Thank you. Next. Okay, we got us our board. We're going to start making our measurement.
Eight inches. Come from this way, 22. Isn't that what we said? 22. Okay, now
we gotta
make us a cut.
Okay, stay tuned. Hang tight. Okay, we're gonna make us a cut.
Here we go. Okay, now I gotta make another cut. Here we go. Okay, that's our cut. Stay tuned.
Okay, what we're doing is rounding off the corners. This will give me a perfect rounding.
Good.
Okay, stay tuned. Let me get my saw. Okay, got my saw. Let's see how to do this.
We just got to sand it. Stay tuned.
Next. Hey, sand away. Okay, it looks like we're going to be sanding it for a little while. We want to make sure we get all these corners all around it all. We don't need no splinters while we're using our mouth station. Also, do not need any of the wood catching on the mouse wire. Okay, that's enough hand sanding for right now. Next, stay tuned. We're gonna put a little cushion with some covering over on there. So stay tuned. Next, in case you guys are wondering what I'm doing, I'm making another one for my friend Grant. So stay tuned while I make this other cut. Okay, let me get my other saw. Take it in. Ready, set. So. Ta-da! Got another couple round corners there, buddy. Stay tuned. Next. Okay, what we're doing here is we're marking from the end here to here 20 inches. That'll be actually to the edge of my arm on the chair. This is going to be a way for me to mount this to the chair so it will not move. We do not need it moving. Thank you very much. Stay tuned. Next. Okay, now what we're doing is drilling a couple holes so we can drill some, screw some screws in to hold this little piece of block on the bottom. Okay, stay tuned. Well, here you can watch me drill. Thank you very much. Okay, next we're going to put some screws in. Maybe we'll show you how, maybe not. Stay tuned, bye. Okay, what we did, we got us a clamp so we can hold the board on so we can screw the screws in our little holes there. Thank you very much. I got to find my screws first. Stay tuned, be right back. Okay, now we got the little board screwed on here. Got three screws in it. Now, we're going to need to take this and screw that on there. And that'll be our front mounting point to the front of the chair arm so it does not move, spin, and make mouses fall down and run around on the floor. Okay, so stay tuned. Next. We'll have this screwed on. Stay tuned. Next. Okay, now we got it screwed together. We're going to use this side and drill two holes to keep this thing from tilting like this, so that our mouses will stay up here. And we're going to put a border around this thing to keep the mouses from falling off the side. And we're going to put some kind of little thing with a hole in it to keep the mouses' wires in, where they can slide in and out no problem. Okay, stay tuned. Next. Okay, guys, we got the thing constructed. Now, we have to see how this is going to work. This is an old junky chair, so do not say nothing about me screwing holes through the arm, because it's not going to stay like that. Now, this chair is old junky. It's about going in the trash. But I need this armchair mouse station more than I care about the arm on the chair. So, one sec. I have drilled two holes here and here, and I'm sticking two screws in there. One there, get it started, get that one started. This is going down into the wood. Well, I thought it was going down into the wood. Maybe I need longer screws. That's what it is. Let me go get me some longer screws. Let's don't use them screws. We got some longer cabinet screws. So, I will be right back. Stay tuned. We'll have the right screw. Okay, we now have the right screw. Big old long bad boys, huh? I don't know exactly how long. I think we're 3 inches. Okay, let's see. See what happens. Okay, let's get this one started. Get it where I want it. Well, it didn't hold on to nothing. So what happened there? Don't know yet. Something's not working. We got another way to do this. Okay. What we're going to do is we're going to screw a couple screws in the front. Maybe. Let's take a moment and decide what we're going to do. Stay tuned. Okay, we're going to try this again. What I did is I put a board up underneath, so it will sandwich together with the screws from the top, and it'll sandwich together. So here we go, we're gonna try. See how this works. I'm not sure that caught anything. I think it did. Nope. We need to use the longer screws. Hey, Toby. go. Now, so what I'm going to do is put me a border around here, a little small border, a cushion. And a little mouse pad, like so. So my mouses will be like this. And I will be able to do all my mousing, like so. I think I'm gonna move this over to the left a little bit more. And then that'll be all. Then that'll be good. Then we'll show you the finished product. Stay tuned. Next. What I'm doing now is I'm putting on this little guard rail so that we'll keep the mouse from falling off the side. Got a couple screws in there. Got one on the other side. I finished putting them screws on. And then we'll put a couple notches on this end. We'll put a couple more screws here on this end and put a couple notches so the mouse wire can run in and out, and it'll keep my mouses from falling off. That's what we want. That's looking like it's gonna work there, fellas. Okay, stay tuned for the next. Okay guys, I think we got fully functional mouse station. This dumb tripod will stay still. Okay. Now I just need to get some material and cover it. Upholster it, I should say. So now, mouses will not fall out the front. Got two little notches here. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 screws holding this guard rail on. That was an old piece of blinds. Took an old blind and cut it. Pretty stiff. Works pretty good. So this is going to be the only video I have seen on YouTube about making a mouse station for your Lazy Boy. See, I run two computers, one on the left and one on the right. There you'll see. I want to run on. I want to run one on the left. It's a 32-inch. Computer there, Lazy Boy, and a computer over here, not as big of a, I think it's a 22-inch, 23-inch, anyway, and got a computer beside the bed. I got more computers than you can shake a stick at. Alright, that's going to be how to make your own Lazy Boy mouse, double mouse station, that is. And after I get it covered, I'll show you the total end result. Think it's gonna work, y'all. All right. See you shortly. Stay tuned. Next. Okay, guys, what we're going to be doing here is I got some material, which is an old sheet. Got a pretty nice little lion design on there, which we don't matter, or it doesn't matter what kind of design it's got. All it's going to do is be using as material to cover, and we're going to staple this very tight to cover our mouse station. So Give me a few minutes, I'm going to cut it, and then we're going to start. I need to cut two pieces so it'll be nice and thick, and then we'll start stapling it. Okay, so give me a minute, be right back. Stay tuned, next. Okay, we got the material cut, and we're going to start stapling from the back end and working our way around until we get to the front, and then we'll put our side back on. And we'll be and put it back on the chair, and then we'll be done. Stay tuned. Let me get this thing stapled. It might take a minute. I got to make sure the staple gun works first. Okay. So stay tuned. Be right back. Next. Okay, we got everything all stapled. Got everything pretty tight, and it looks pretty good. That way your arm won't get stuck. Just slide up and down. Very good. Very good. Next, we gotta put our little border back around. Once we do that, then we'll show you the finished product back on the chair, operating. Thank you. Stay tuned. Next. Okay, now we have the double mouth station screwed down in two places in the arm. Don't say anything about me doing that, because this is going to be permanent. This is the way I want my chair. This is an old junky broke chair anyway. So anyway, this is to make it more functional for me operating two computers with the same on the same side with two mice. I should say. Okay. So let me see if I can get this right. Okay. So I can operate mouse on this side. And I can operate mouse on this side. We got United Artists, James Bond. We're going to watch some James Bond. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed the video. So this is how you make a quick double mouse pad station. Double mouse station for your lazyboy. Junky old lazyboy armchair. Double mouse station. And this has been David O'Rourke. Thank you very much for taking a look at my video. Please like and share. I appreciate it. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe right down there. Right down there. Subscribe. Ooh, I was wondering where somewhere over here. Ha ha. Okay. See you on the next one. Thanks, guys. Bye.